Hello everyone, welcome to Harjeet's World and my name is Harjeet and once again I'm back with new vacancy. This vacancy is also open in India. Before I go ahead with the vacancy, I would like to tell you guys that I have almost 8 years of flying experience, 4 years in domestic and 4 years with international airline with Qatar Airways. My channel for the first time or you have not subscribed till now, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and do hit the like button. And you can also follow me on Instagram. My ID is Harjeet Dreams. So let's start with the video. The vacancies I'm going to talk about is with the brand new airline which is getting launched in year 2022. So they are planning to start the airline in year 2022 in summer. So the airline I'm talking about is Akasa Air. They have various vacancies opened. So I am going to talk about cabin crew vacancy. So they have various vacancies open in cabin crew as well. So they have 3 cabin crew vacancies availability. So which means cabin crew and then senior cabin crew and then IFM, which means is in-flight manager. So the number of vacancies in each positions, it's approximately 100. So let me explain in detail. So which means like for cabin crew, they are looking 100 cabin crew, they are looking 100 senior cabin crew, and then next is 100 IFMs, which is in-flight managers. So right now I'm going to give you eligibility criteria for a cabin crew and then followed by senior cabin crew and then followed by IFMs. So let's talk about their eligibility criteria. The minimum education qualification they are asking for is 12th pass. Minimum age requirement for a cabin crew is 18 years. Minimum height requirement for female is 156 centimeters and for a male it's 170 centimeters. In for language, they're asking you should be fluent in Hindi and English. And the next requirement is weight should be proportionate to height. Vacancy is open for male and female and freshers can also apply for this vacancy. So this was the eligibility criteria for a cabin crew. Now I'm going to talk about senior cabin crew. So let's talk about senior cabin crew. For senior cabin crew, the eligibility criteria remains the same. Only the add-on points I'll talk about. For senior cabin crew, they're asking for 1 to 3 years minimum experience. For senior cabin crew, they're asking for 2 SEP recurrent training endorsement. I'm sure if you're already flying, you're already aware of this. So I would like to explain those candidates who have never flown before. For them, I would like to explain this. What does that mean? So recurrent training is a training which is done every year. So you get a license once you complete your training, initial training, and then you get a license for different types of aircraft. So every year you have to get renewed your license. So for renewing your license, you have to go through a training every year, which may be for a week or two. And for senior cabin crew, there's an age difference. So minimum age requirement for a senior cabin crew is 20 years. So you should be 20 years of age when you're applying for a senior cabin crew. So that was all about senior cabin crew. Now I would like to talk about IFM, which is in-flight manager. For in-flight manager, the minimum age requirement is 21. So the next requirement for IFM is you should have minimum 1 year of flying experience as a senior cabin crew. So these were the requirements for cabin crew, senior cabin crew, and for the IFM. So now I'm going to tell you how you can apply. For applying, I will give you a link in the description box where you need to click. So once you open the link, you can see the vacancies. So in whichever vacancy you're interested, you just have to click onto the vacancy. For example, a cabin crew. So you have to open that cabin crew vacancy and you can read the job description and all the details there. And below, there it will be written, I'm interested. So the moment you will click onto I'm interested, you can see a page where you have to upload your CV. There is an option to upload a CV or easy apply or apply with Indeed. So once you upload your CV, after that you can see that you have to fill up other details. which is your name, address, contact number, email address, and if your education qualification, your experience if you have. After that, you have to attach your photograph and a resume, and then you have to submit the application. So that was all about the vacancy and how you can apply. If you really like the video, please do hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Bye.